Well, I'm glad to see a lot of women organizations who got recognized today for International Women's History Month. So, Mr. Speaker, we come together today to celebrate this. This year's theme has been women in business-owned businesses and women in labor. We do so to honor them for their suffrage, their sacrifice, and so that today's generation of young women can learn from their emboldened victory. These women, like Barbara Hackman Franklin, former U.S. Secretary of Commerce, Addie Wyatt, first African-American woman elected international vice president of a major labor union, Norman Yeager, first woman admitted to the floor of the New York Stock Exchange, and Barbara Dusty Rhodes, union leader in the airline industry. These women had the extraordinary grace to fight for the betterment of everyone, regardless of age, race, social class, and most importantly, gender. We've come a long way since Kate Mullaney, who as an Irish immigrant recognized how dangerous working conditions were in their factories in Troy, New York. She successfully organized the first all-female union, even negotiating a wage increase. The Commonwealth, home to American first female CEO of an industrial company, Rebecca Lukens. Rebecca was a pregnant widow and mother of five who purchased her dad's business, Brandywine Iron and Nail. Under her leadership, 10 years later, it was considered the industry leader in meeting the demands of the transportation revolution. Her efforts grew in the company and it thrived, even avoiding a national financial crisis. Ms. Lukens, like countless women across the nation, deserve to be honored and celebrated, as they are a perennial reminder that women can succeed in every field, taking on leadership roles in their homes and in business and labor. What's troubling is that there are an estimated 1.75 billion women in the workforce, and yet equal pay for a woman now equals what a man's salary was 10 years ago. How is that equal? And how are we celebrating and honoring the hard work women if we aren't taking steps to ensure that no female is shortchanged simply because of her gender? In the words of Lilly Ledbetter, those pennies add up to real money. Dorothy Height, the late social activist and Presidential Medal of Freedom recipient, once said, "My mother helped me to understand how not to show off what I knew, but how to use it so that others may benefit." Now is the time to be bold for change, to honor and memorialize women like Rebecca and Dorothy, so that together we are moved closer to the day when society no longer needs prompting in order to value women and girls. Let us not simply use this moment as a fleeting fashion to celebrate them, but let us pause, ponder, and reflect upon the lessons that they have taught and take progressive steps to ensure the continuance of their respective legacies. So today we're celebrating International Women's Day, and this month is National Women's History Month here in Pennsylvania. For centuries, we have witnessed a culture that validated the male experience, while women quietly remained in the shadows. Their roles bound, I know, I see guys smirking, that's okay. Their roles bound and limited to the primary obligations of family and home. They nurtured and advised the men in their lives and worked to bring about change and shape our society. They were often undervalued and still today are underpaid. Let us forever be reminded of the sacrifices these great women have made and commit to a future where the dreams and ambitions of the legacies are realized. Thank you. It is my hope that we need to heed another subtle lesson expressed by Dorothy Height. We cannot not afford to be separate anymore. We have to see that we were all in the same boat. And I want to thank my wonderful women colleagues, because they're all awesome.